Hey, what's up everyone? This is your host Manik. Welcome to another video. So a couple of days ago, amidst all this chaos, we got the new Android 11 beta for a few devices. And I was too excited to see what new features it brings to the table. So after spending nearly 2 days to boot it on my OnePlus 6, I finally managed to boot it, and it was quite a task. So in this video, let's have a quick look at the new Android 11 beta 1 on OnePlus 6. And before we start, if you wish to stay notified about the latest videos, do click on that subscribe button and press the bell icon next to it. And in case you are wondering if the OnePlus 6 series will get Android 11 or not, I would say the chances are high that we will get it, but it won't happen before 2021. But don't worry, we will have quite a few custom ROMs before that. Anyways, let's jump to the new features, and you will see most of these in the final version as well. So first of all, in the notification bar, we now have the notifications categorized automatically. For example, chats and messages will be on the top, and the alerts below them, and so on. And it feels nice and refined, as you don't have to look for an important message in a mess that used to exist in the previous versions of Android, which is just great. Oh, one more thing, we now have chat bubbles like we had in past with the apps like Messenger. So now apps like WhatsApp and messages will support it too, which makes the whole multitasking easier and smooth. And in case you are doing something else, it is handy too. And you can also see the image of sender instead of the app icon, and it feels nice overall. Plus you can go in settings and get your notification history as well. And I really wanted to see this feature, as it helps in case you dismiss a notification accidentally, and you will appreciate it for sure. And that music playback tile has now been moved to the top. It makes it more iOS-like, and I'm not really a fan of it, as some people are going to find it difficult to reach there and control their music playback. But it's there, and from this tile, you can switch over to any external speaker or earphones easily with just a tap, and that is handy. Now the home screen has changed quite a bit, and you have the app suggestions, and the device learns as per your usage and recommends the apps on your home screen itself, and it works. But it isn't that accurate. Now coming to the recents menu, we now have these three new buttons, and firstly, you have a screenshot button to the left to quickly capture, edit or share a screenshot on the go. And next to it, you have a select button to select any text you want from the current screen. And this nifty feature is really helpful, trust me. And if you are really lazy, just like me, just tap on that share button and it will capture a screenshot of the current app and bring up the share sheet directly. Neat, isn't it? Now another new thing that we have with this Android version is in permissions. And we now have the extra permission layer. So now you can permit an app access to a specific permission for that session only. And I feel it's a next step in the Android security system. And it's good to have it. Apart from this, we have the new screen recorder officially. Let's hope it does not get removed in the final stable version. Plus the new icon styles, dark mode scheduling, and you can even resize the video in picture-in-picture mode, and other tiny things like autofill and keyboard, app pinning, and a lot more. And what do I feel about it? Well, the last couple of Android versions have been minor updates, cosmetically, but under the hood, they have some really good improvements that refines the overall experience. And this beta is in no way ready to be used as a daily driver, but it's a baby step in the right direction. So that was it. This was your first look at the Android 11 beta 1. Do let me know the feature you like the most in Android 11. So do like this video if it helps you out, and subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys in the next one.